Hey everyone, and welcome back to a new episode of our Hegemony 3 Clash of the Engines Let's Play. Episode 7 today, and last time around we took over Antium over here, which is fantastic, so secured our border. In this area we upgraded a few more cities and get a few upgrades in our cities so we can start recruiting some better units, which would be fantastic, so get some heavier units and some cavalry and archers and some hoplites and things like that. So it's definitely probably do. After we've taken over hopefully both of these cities here, we may sort of do a bit of an army upgrade and restructure our army and all that kind of stuff, but we're definitely feeling a lot more secure about how we're going. I think everywhere is pretty safe, and we're not really under threat from anyone too much at the moment, which is good. So I'm just going to jump into diplomacy quickly and have a look at a few of these factions. So Independent Rome has obviously gone, which is good, and the Volshai, it looks like they've gone as well, so I actually can't see them. They're not here anymore, so they must have only had the one city. Well, they've been taken over as well by the Sabines or something. I would have thought they'd have more than one city. So it looks like they're gone as well. So we've wiped them out too. So the Maasai, so how are we going? So the Maasai is actually stronger than us, which is interesting. So that's what I sort of mentioned about earlier in the game, that you're going to have like your own, the AI empire is actually sort of expanding on their own. So they're actually probably bigger than us. So they're probably going to be quite a significant empire. So I suspect that once we get a little bit further out, we're going to start running into some really big empires and start having some pretty epic war, so that should be quite a lot of fun. So they're actually, hostility is only at 24, which is not too much. Intimidation's at -8, so we're going to cost us 70 a month to get a truce, but we don't really want to do that. Sabines are fearful of us, so they're quite a lot bit weaker than us, which is quite interesting. So they've actually looks like they're, I thought they would have had a couple of cities over here, and they've definitely got this one here, so maybe they're being picked off as well by other factions, so they're quite a bit weaker than us. So it's still going to cost us 20 a month to have a truce. I don't really see the point in doing that. And what about Vey over here? So they're definitely hostile. Sabines, yeah. Definitely hostile, but they're sort of nearly about 1,000 score or power strength, whatever you want to call it, there. So they're actually quite strong. So I suspect they must have stretched out this way a little bit as well. So this could be quite an interesting little expedition we're going to have over here. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually move over this way. Move all our units over here. We take over this livestock farm and hook up into our network. So I'll probably come into the camp there. We'll see how we go. How much actually do walls cost? Wooden walls. They cost 25 income. May leave it for the moment. We haven't really been attacked all that much, so that's why I'm sort of thinking it's not really worth it. Really worth doing it at the moment. I think we're pretty safe and secure with how everything's going, so we're not really worth doing at the moment, so. Excuse me, guys. Yawn. So we're in late winter, we're still 1,000 food left, which is quite a bit, really. I assume late winter's not going to last a whole lot longer. And, yeah, so that's good. So I think next time around, we may sort of maybe expand a few more of our food production buildings and see if we can even get more income. So just make sure that we definitely sort of are well and true. I think we're actually going to take over this one here. So I'm actually going to create another worker unit while we're here. Create some Latin workers. We're going to take this one here. Given that we've sort of got some units in the area, it should be fairly safe. So whatever else is pretty maxed out. There's a little bit of capacity here that maybe we could. That's only two people, so it's not really probably worth worrying about. So everything's going pretty well, I think. Lacking wood. Why are you lacking wood? You shouldn't be. You are hooked up into the city, aren't you? Oh, weren't you? Maybe you weren't. No, it looks like the camp wasn't. Interesting, right? That's good. At least we've done that one now, so that's good. Can be a little bit hard sometimes to see what's not hooked up and what is. Like, I know this sort of is an icon, but it can be quite easy to sort of get them lost in the the jumble of everything that's going on, so. Looks like this city's quite well defended. Sora. It's got some significant walls on there. Most of the cities actually seem to have walls on them, don't they? Whereas none of our cities do, so. We're definitely spending our money on military units, I suspect, is what we're choosing to do there. This camp is out of food, which is interesting, so actually we could take that one over quite easily. I don't really want to do that, given that it's quite close to a few of their cities. I don't really want to provoke a big war. I'm pretty happy to just sort of sit back and do our own things. How are we going here? So they've got some axemen. So they've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units in there, so 95 capacity. I think we may be okay. Although it is quite close to Vey, I don't really want to provoke a big response from them. We've only got one unit there. Alright, we're actually going to take, we're going to attempt to take this one over. See how we go here. I think we should be more than fine. I think we've got enough to do it. We're actually going to take, we're going to take a levies and capture this livestock farm here. And then we're actually going to move our levies sort of over this way, just to make sure that they don't send any units around this way, because we can see all the way through here. So we should be able to see when they're coming around this way. And then just make sure they don't come around. Where are you guys going? No, don't bother going around that far. It's not really worth it, I don't think. Because if you sort of click on, if you have a big unit and you click on like a siege or city, they sort of automatically place their units around the city, and that's how they sort of set it out. But I don't really want them to come all the way around here into the back. So I think we're just going to leave these guys here. This may actually be our blocking force there. Leave a couple of units there. I think we're going to be fine in terms of the battle. Well, I may just pull off a few units and make sure that these ones go okay. I think we're doing pretty well for now. Couple of units here, and we've got a few levies as well fighting here, so I think we're going to be more than fine. These ones are suspended, which is good, and we've... All right, that's done. So all those units have been defeated, which is quite good. And we are going to siege this city, which is about to fall. There we go. So we've taken over the city, Sistra, as well. And hostility has increased, which is not surprising. So we've also taken over this one here. So we're going to hook up this livestock farm into there, and then create a supply route from there into the bridgehead there, into the bridge there, I think. There we go. So that's going to hook up into Rome and all that kind of stuff. So, I know, there it was. Interesting. So actually, it's quite interesting. When you actually, sort of capture a bridge unit, like the, you know, one of the markers, and then you've got to create a supply line in. But once you build a bridge, that looks like the supply line disappears. So this one actually wasn't hooked up into Rome, which was the same problem we had over here. Like, we had created a supply line for the capture point, but then once the bridge was built, you had to create a separate one. So seems a little bit counterintuitive. I would have thought maybe it's just, given that you've already created one, it should just sort of remain there. But anyway, that's fine. At least we know that now. So that's good. So it means our city over here is hooked up. I'm actually gonna leave the wooden walls on at the moment. It's just a level 2 city. We are going to upgrade the population as well there, which is good. So make sure that's all done. Almost, Rome can almost be upgraded as well, which is quite cool. So it's a level 4 city as already. Create hoplites and that kind of stuff. We are going to capture some of these units. I think it's definitely worth it. So I just may select a few units to capture. And they should sort them out pretty quickly. There we go, that's good. So it's got 6 there. How many is over here? We've got 10. So we need another 10 somewhere. So there's one done. So this spearman. So how many is in here? 12. So I'm actually going to send this one over here. It's going to fill out our livestock farm there. What else do we have in this area? We've got vineyard over here and fishery over here. I think I may just leave these until we've taken over Bay, just so there's no sort of problems. We're just going to push through this way, sort of just explore this area a little bit more. Because it looks like there's a pathway through here. And also down this way as well. Pirate fleet. There we go. First pirate fleet. Where are they coming in? They're coming into Antium. Alrighty. So I've never really fought pirates before, so I don't really know how this works. 1250 strength. Raider hoplites. Alrighty. So maybe we're going to need another unit. So what we're going to do is actually create another unit of spearmen and send both of our units back. Victory points gained. How on earth does that... What are victory points? No idea. No idea what victory points are. Assets. Where's the objectives? Objectives. So these are objectives, aren't they? Victory points. Here we go. So these are victory points. 4 out of 10. So what have we got here? Hegemony objectives. What else have we got? Military hegemony. Ensure your faction's dominance on land by maintaining a military force at least twice the size of the combined forces of all active factions. Current required victory points. All right, so that means we've actually got a very big military, which is quite cool. So we're doing something right. So these guys are coming very, very quickly. So we may have a little bit of a trouble here in Antium. Maybe we should have left the walls on, but we'll see how we go. A little bit of a funny animation there. They're sort of going on their side. Why not? If that's what works for you, then good on you. So units come over here. This is coming back to the city. So we'll see how we go. So it looks like they're just going to deposit one unit of Raider Hoplites. There we go. So I think we should be fine. We've definitely got a garrison here, so that's going to be fine. And we're going to bring our units over here to attack these guys. And they're already attacking, which is good. And don't you think this raider ship's going to be a problem? I'm not sure if it's going to be... It doesn't look like it's attacking us or anything, so... Let's see how we go. So they're going to come in, they're starting to start raising us, but I think we're going to be fine because we actually engaged them quite shortly. And this one's almost done, so she can pull these guys out here and attack them from there. And then come in from the rear of the flank and attack them there. And we've got our javelin. Javelin is in there. So actually, this is an upgraded unit. So obviously they've done a bit of damage before. What have we got over here? Had a bit of a battle here. I'll do a bit of battle there. So I should select both our units. We should be more than fine here. It's sort of one on two. So that shouldn't be a problem at all. Cool. So we've got our levies done there. This one was rebelling, wasn't it? So what we're going to do is actually just put in one unit there for the moment. And I'm going to join together a few slave units and sort those out. There we go. Maybe put in a couple of units. We're going to create some hostages as well. Etruscan hostages, and we'll send those over to Rome, and that should sort out the rebellion problem. How are we going over here, guys? Yeah, we're going okay. It's actually low morale already. That actually ran out of food, so there we go. That wasn't a problem. Cool, so that's done. So can we actually attack this ship here now? Terrain inaccessible. No, so we can't really do anything there, so I'm assuming they're probably just going to go away after a little while. So we're actually going to just leave three units there now, given that we know what we know now, that we're going to start getting maybe some pirate raids in on our coast. We're just going to leave a few more units in there. Have to look at, if we ever get one in Ostia, we may actually have to build up some units there as well, but we'll see how we go. Why are you guys going that way? You're going the wrong way. No, go this way. Attack them. There we go. That's better. Not really sure what's happening there. That's fine. Should be more than fine here. Although we are losing this one quite heavily, so let's see how we go. Now we're starting to get back in the fight. Cool. Alright, so that's all good. So I've created some hostages here, so we're going to send them over to Rome over here. And we do have a garrison there, so we should be fine in terms of rebellion, so not a problem there at all. Did upgrade this city, so that's good. And we've won this battle, which is good as well. So actually, going to send our units through here, just so we can sort of see in this area what's happening over this way. And we are outside like recruitment range, so we're actually not going to get recruitments or recruits back. So we'll have to go back in and recover this unit. Definitely just want to see this area because we haven't discovered it. So sort of see what's over here and what we can. What's there? We go another city. So we've got Tachna. Etruscan city. Interesting. All right, there we go. So send a couple of our units back, get recruits and stuff, all that done. And then once our hostages are back in, we'll actually move on Vay and see how we can go with taking over them. Once we've got those two, I think we're in pretty safe in terms of like Rome. So, yeah, we're going to be pretty good shape for that. So everything else is going pretty well, pretty happy. So food production is still good, obviously, like because it builds up over time. So going up a little bit slowly. I'll just jump in and have a look at a few of our things, see if we can upgrade any of these. So we can upgrade this one into resource production, which would be good. That's one there. The fishery over here we hadn't done before, so there's another one. I think we've done everything else though, yeah. So I don't think we can upgrade them any further. No, we can't. No, it's sort of only a once-off thing, which is totally fine. What about the mines? We hadn't upgraded those, had we? No, we hadn't. So we also created another worker here. You know, I forgot about, there we go. So you can come in and grab this independent farm there, but also you're going to upgrade both of these mines here, so it's going to give us a little bit more income. But we've done everything else, so yep, that's fine. Hadn't done that one actually, so then we're going to upgrade that one. It's a bit more food. Just going to jump around, make sure we've upgraded all our food production ones. I don't really probably see the point in upgrading the other ones. Like mines, obviously, probably not. Done this one either. Probably not lumber camps really. I think we're pretty good on lumber most of the time. But yeah, see how we go. Haven't done this one either. So that's that, and we'll get this one as well. So that's probably too much lumber, but that'd be fine. I think it should sort itself out over time. So it's gonna give us a bit more food, a bit more income, all that kind of stuff. So it's just good. So we've got our hostages here running over. Deposit themselves in Rome quite quickly. What have we got here? We've got workers. So it looks like they're going to capture this fishery. That's fine. You can do that if you want. I think we will have to leave a few units here, maybe. I'm not really sure. Is this one not hooked up? So that's actually not hooked up properly, it looks like. Why not? No supply line. Surely you should be hooked up into Rome now. You've actually hooked up into this city here. What's going on there? You haven't got supply lines here either. Is that the supply line? I swear that's the supply line icon, isn't it? That little thing there. Just jump into the help, have a look at the supply lines, see if it shows us the icon here, supply lines. Yep. Supply line blocked. Mostly be blocked by snow, flooded or rough water. Flooded marshland, rough water. Interesting. Alrighty, not quite sure. It looks like this one's fine. From what I can see, this supply line's active. This one, the camp's fine, but this one's not. So we're just going to delete these and maybe rebuild them. So can we create one to there? This doesn't fix that supply line issue. Maybe you can't hook up into like a bridge. Maybe it's sort of got to come into a city. Maybe that's the problem we've got. What about if we can't hook up into Rome, can we? No, we can't. So what if we create one over here? So that's fixed the problem. Lacking lumber, that should be fine. That should sort itself out. This one still hasn't though, so I'm not really quite sure why it's going on there. Supply lines. Sisera, Rome, resource production. Don't really know. Unless it was the upgrade. I don't think it would be up there. Oh, it could be the upgrade. Yeah, it looks like the upgrade. Okay. There we go, that was my fault. So delete that one and just put it back into there. So it looks like the upgrade, once it's upgrading, like it's not producing or something. So once the upgrade is done, that should be more than fine. Cool, all right, we'll just keep an eye on that. Farm captured, which is awesome. So we should put those, probably just put that straight into our bridge there, which should put us into the network. There we go, all done. So that's more stuff there. So supply, I'm gonna upgrade this one as well for our resource production. Yeah, it's good. So these ones are done. Yeah, so once the upgrade's done, the supply line goes back to normal. Good to know. So there we go. Fair bit of extra money and all that kind of stuff per week, which is brilliant. So that is good. Cool. All right, so how are we going here? So all our units are back. Our hostages are back in the city, which means we no longer need a garrison, which is awesome. So we'll have both our units. We are going to leave a couple here. So what are we going to leave? I think we're just going to leave a levies and a spearman just over here, because we might come around this way from the top around here, and then leave a couple here, just make sure nothing else comes up from that way. But everything else we're going to grab, all our military units over here, just move them all over this way. We've still got a couple of units of slaves here, just going to join those two together. New objective, it's just sort of like a defeat some units to get some money, that's fine. We do it, but we're not going to go out of our way to do it, so it's not a problem there. Enemy force. Where's an enemy force? Over here. Not really surprising that the Vey is coming after us. Where are they coming? So they're coming around this way from the top. So we've got a few units here, so we should be more than fine. So what we're going to do is just bring our units out over here. Yeah, so they're coming around this way. There is like a few units in here, though. So we've got like two spearmen, two axemen. What you can do is you can sort of send one back over here into this here, just in case we lose this initial battle. And we'll see how we go. Can upgrade this unit though, this one here, so... I really sort of want the extra missile damage though, so we might leave that until they get a little bit more experience. Just gonna move you guys back there like that. There we go, that should be fine. Hopefully, we'll see how we go here. Axemen seem quite weak from what I've seen. Let me just pause and have a look at their stats. Yeah, I'm not really sure. Do look quite weak. From what I've seen, anyway. They really seem to last. They're smaller units, so maybe they're sort of just raiding units. Maybe they're more designed for raiding. I mean, it's good because it means they've got four units out of Vey that's not there anymore. So, what we're going to do is send our army around here like this. So you're going to sit around there like that, and just going to grab our skirmishers, make sure they're sitting behind our lines. There we go. Cool. So actually, Vey, it looks like they've downgraded their walls, so they did have sort of better walls from what I saw. Maybe they've had to get some extra money or something, so... Cool. So everything's going really well. So we've got a... We've got too many units here, don't we? Didn't mean to have that one, so I'm just going to send these guys back over here. Yeah, you go back over there. We only need two of you. There we go. That's better. Victory points lost. I'm assuming that's going to be the military one, yeah. So we actually required 1,200, so... A few factions are getting a bit stronger, which is totally fine. How are we going over here with our battle? So actually looks like they engaged our skirmishes, which we didn't really want, but that's fine. I think we're doing pretty well. Looks like they're about to break anyway. Looks like our skirmishes actually defeated the Axemen. So the Axemen definitely aren't very strong. Victory point lost. What on earth did we lose there? Not really sure. That's fine. Cool. So they're both done. So we're just going to grab our two spearmen and if we can get them back in formation. There we go. We have our skirmishes behind. We sort of want to have them in like the battle line if we can, because we do get some like charge bonuses. Looks like trying to flank us, come around the back, get out into our skirmishes. We don't really do that though, so I think we should be fine. Like it's especially with our skirmishes here, our ranged units, we should be fine. Do a fair bit more damage than what they're going to do to us. So I'm just going to leave that for a little bit. Like, keep an eye on what we're doing over here. So how are we going in Vey? What have they got over here? So they've got nothing. So that's awesome. So we're actually going to send our units straight in. We're not going to worry about waiting for anything else. We're just going to send all our units straight in because they've basically got no defenses here that I can see, because they actually sent all their units out. So that was definitely a mistake on their part. So it was a good time to attack by us. It sort of just worked out as lucky that we were sort of going to come over there anyway. But yeah, it worked out well. So what we're going to do is just start, going to just capture a few of these different things. So we're going to take over this mine and the vineyard here. Maybe probably actually the fishery as well. Probably actually the vineyard and the fishery with our two slaves. So we're going to need a unit per each to actually capture. And then we'll send our slaves over. So one slave is going to come over here. And the other one, if I could select them there, is going to come over this way. There we go. Cool, so there'll be some extra resources and all that kind of stuff. And then we'll capture these areas once we're done taking over Vey. But they have no garrison really, they've only got 30. Which is fine, I think we're going to be more than fine taking over this city, so that is really good. So, did we send a unit over here? Yes, we did, we're going to send them back now. There we go, and defeated units there. Yep, cool, no problem. And send these ones back as well into the city, so. So yeah, a fairly easy win there. Not really sure what the victory points thing is. I think it sort of keeps fluctuating here with the military hegemony. And how did you get past our lines, honestly? So we're going to send you and attack you guys there. And you're going to attack these ones. Just going to pull one of our spearmen off as well. We don't really need them. Definitely got more than enough force to take over. A little bit annoying that victory point thing keeps coming up, but that's fine. We won't worry too much about that. Put our units back into the siege, and we're almost actually done sieging, so that's awesome. So that's been another city that we've taken over. Capturing both these units down here. And everything else is good. No problems. No problems at all. There we go. We've captured Vey. So there we go. We've actually now expanded over both sides of the river, and Rome is definitely well and truly secure, which is absolutely brilliant. So first thing we're going to do is actually create some hostages and put a couple of units in just to sort of as a bit of a garrison, just to get there, make sure the morale and all that kind of stuff is fine for the time being. Just going to finish off this last unit here. So Vey, they still do have... that's right, they were quite strong, weren't they? Yeah, so they've definitely got some more cities around, so... which is totally, totally fine, so... just going to set up our units here. We are going to create a couple and take over some of these resource buildings over this way. Just grab another one here, take over these. I think what we're going to do is create a couple of workers from Rome. And... because we don't have any slaves in this area, which is fine. Cool, we've actually captured all of these two extra resource points. So send our slaves into the buildings, pull our military units back. If I can select them, there we go, that one, and you. Pull you guys back, just sit you there, and then we'll hook these back up into our supply lines. Like so, there we go. Some extra food and all that kind of stuff. Actually upgrade these ones as well. Resource production, and same here. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Capturing these ones, which is good. And put Vey. I think we're going to create a line to our, yeah, we can't do that, into our bridgehead there. I think that's probably all what we need to do there. I don't probably see there any point connecting up to Sisera as well. Probably no real benefit to doing that. So we're going to jump into Vey. Can we upgrade? We can't do anything. What have you got here? We've actually got stables, which are cavalry. May leave that for the moment. We've got a fair bit of extra income, which is awesome. It's also got wooden walls, which we can see, so that's good. So I may just leave those both sort of defended like that, but I think everything else is... I think we're doing pretty well. No major dramas, which is awesome, so... capturing these areas. How's everything else going? Good. Actually, I'm going to send another unit over to capture this mine there. I think our workers would have finished by now. Can upgrade Rome as well, so how much is this going to cost us? 400 wood, so that's definitely... fine. So increased food consumption, better population, and more upgrade slots. So it's good to actually upgrade that. And we've captured both of these things. We're going to hook those back up into Vay. And yeah, so send both our units back over. Send our hostages out of recruits. That's going to take a little bit of time, which is totally fine. Yeah, go around both of our workers, which are done, I assume. Yeah, we are. Send one into there, and then send the other one into the farm over there. I'm going to also upgrade both of these while we're here. Make sure we've got well and truly enough food for the coming winter. That's good. I captured this one. I think this one we've got recruits. It does. So I actually create some workers here. And they'll send them over into the mine over there, which will be good. So there we go, guys. That's what we are. That's sort of our empire at the moment. Still quite small, but definitely expanding. So I think we're doing quite well, really. Faction discovered. Clevson. New faction. Spearmen. Who are the Clevson? The Umbri. They're stronger than us as well, so that's quite interesting. But they're not really hostile towards us, so that's not too bad. So it's still going to cost us quite a bit of money. Vay absolutely hates us. They are, 96 hostility, which is totally fine. Sabines, they are wary of us because they're quite weak by the looks of it. And the Marcy, they are definitely not scared of us either. So definitely, like, I think we're doing well, but looking at those rankings, we're obviously sort of not, you know, too far. We're not, like, sort of above the curve or anything. I don't think it's going to be too easy. So I think once we sort of start running into some of these extra bigger factions and stuff, we're going to start with some much bigger battles. So it looks like Vay is sending through a unit of spearmen. So let's just send our units back over this way. If we can, we can come through this way, I think, by the looks of it. Yeah, we can come through here. So we're just going to send them there. I suspect they're just going to capture our fishery. So we may have to look at taking over Tarchna over there at some point in the future. Connect that up into Vay. Still waiting on recruits there. So I think what we're going to do is, workers, which we've already done, so that's good. Yep, so capturing our fishery, which is not unexpected, really. So there we go. So they've created a camp over here. I think we're actually going to come over and take that camp over. We don't really want them sitting there. There we go. Send them over there. We'll capture that camp and probably we'll keep that one and let it sort of build up. So we're going to lose this one, but that's okay. It's not too much of a drama. Food production is really quite good, which is awesome. So I think we should well and truly be fine for food. So beans and stuff have stopped a lot of their attacks, which is good. We've got another force coming through here, so they definitely hates us, which is totally to be expected. So these guys are actually leaving, so we may just sort of leave this fishery. Don't sort of keep running after having like a back and forth thing. We may even come look at, may just actually push these two units through here, have a look at Tarchna, and then if it's like not that well defended, we actually sort of bring these our main army through and take over that city. And that should, given there's a river through there, I suspect that's going to be a little bit more better or easier to defend rather than what we've got at the moment. So I think we're going pretty, I think it's going really well. So I'm not really quite happy with that. I think we probably could expand our lumber production. Like, we are sort of using upgrades and stuff a lot more than what we were. So maybe we should upgrade a few of our lumber things. So we're actually going to do that. So we're going to create some workers. So one worker for that one there. I'm actually going to create two workers. Probably just two. We'll fill out this one and take over this one. And then we're going to create workers here and take over this one as well. So that's going to be another extra three. We may take this one a little bit later on as well, but we'll see how we're going for there. So the mine is hooked up and we're going to upgrade that with resource production. There we go. So almost won this battle, which is good. And there we go, we've taken over that. So I'm just going to move our units through. So there's the city there. So she moves them to here. I think that should be enough to get line of sight on that thing. We've got a fight on over here with the Umbrians. And yeah, going pretty well. Definitely we'll take over this city at some point. Probably not quite yet. Given we've got a lot of income and stuff, we can probably actually just build a few units over here somewhere and actually just take them over rather than bring our main army through. Because actually we haven't ever been attacked from this direction by another faction, so I think we're pretty safe just leaving a few units over this way. This area is well enough defended. And yeah, so we're taking that one over. I'm just going to capture this camp there. How are we going over here? So they've actually got, they do have a few units here. So they've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units. So it's going to take a little bit more effort. So it's just going to pull back a little bit. Pull back into our territory there. Capture this camp. I think what we may do, guys, is we're only at 30 minutes, so I'm going to put a cut in here quite shortly. I think we should maybe start restructuring our army, given that we have a lot of income now. Raid is coming through here, though we didn't actually get a notification of a raid, so maybe they're coming towards this camp. But either way, we're going to be fine. I think what we're going to do is actually start upgrading some of our units, so get rid of a few of our spearmen. And they're coming through this way. Yep, so they are coming towards us, that's fine. And it actually looks like we've got another one here as well. Oh, that's us. so what we want to do is actually get rid of maybe a few spearmen and then upgrade them with into hoplites and maybe some of our skirmish units, transform them to archers, and also grab some cavalry as well, so a bit of speed, and we can maybe use those as our, like, our mobile defense force. And yeah, may sort of do that next episode, may sort of restructure things and get our army up, and then we can sort of start pushing out again. But I think we've expanded out pretty quickly really in the last couple of episodes, so don't really want to push it too far. Cool. All right, guys, I'm going to put a cut in the episode here. Hope you've enjoyed the episode today, and also hope you're enjoying this series. As always, it would be absolutely amazing if you could subscribe to the channel and like the video. That would be enormously, enormously appreciated. So, but until then, hope you've all had a good day wherever you're watching from, and I'll see you all for the next episode.